they were balanced, you know, not too powerful, not too overbearing, like the Roman women of their day, Livia, the poisoning to get ahead, but rather balanced women, balanced society, centered around the aristocratic couple, not around male oligarchy and the democratic society of Athens and Roman oligarchy, but centered around the private life of the aristocratic couple. And that I find endearing. Funny jokes, even the ancients were writing jokes, and there's the famous joke about whether Roman noblewoman or Etruscan noblewoman were more virtuous. And so Tarquinius Superbus and a Roman nobleman were sitting at dinner, and each of them were contemplating whose wife was more virtuous. Each of them thought their wife was more virtuous. They went home to find out the Roman woman was home spinning, the Etruscan woman was drunk at a banquet with her friends, and each of them thought their wife was more virtuous. Etruscan women, they were always adorned in public, beautiful, intricate bronze and gold jewelry that is very similar to the jewelry we wear today. And that's because they were very much a part of public life. And in fact, every Etruscan woman was destined to marry, and the status of her family was just as important to Etruscan genealogy as that of the man that she married. Many people find it atrocious that, you know, women, you know, subjected themselves to prostitution to be able to afford their own dowries. But in a way, in Etruscan society, sex was also used as an apotropaic device. And so that means that everything in the Etruscan world was tied to their spirituality and had a spiritual function. So in that way, you know, prostitution was also used as some way in a spiritual way. So it was a very profound way, in my opinion, to afford a dowry for their wedding. Sexuality was often used in paintings as an apotropaic device to ward off evil spirits. And in fact, you know, in the Greek and Roman world, the mythology was centered around male gods. But in the Etruscan world, it was centered around female gods, and gods often changed gender. And, you know, the Etruscans had a similar pantheon as the Greeks and Romans. But, you know, it was the adaptation of women in the society, you know, that was different. And so with Etruscan women, for example, Aphrodite, in the Etruscan sense, she represented sex and death. So perhaps one of the things we've lost in contemporary Italian society is the celebration of women and public and political life, and also a celebration of female sexuality. We've gone from Greek historians in the 4th century BC writing of the many virtuous qualities of the customs regarding women in the Etruscan world to contemporary historians and contemporary journalists writing about Berlusconi and Bunga Bunga parties. Etruscan women had a reputation among the Greek and Roman counterpart societies as being sluts. Now let me ask you, if you are permitted to dine in public with your friends and with men that are not your husband, does that make you a slut? So why are the Etruscan women relevant? Etruscan women are more similar to the women of the Western world than any other ancient civilization. In fact, for example, they wore makeup, they wore eyeliner, they wore powder, but they considered the art of cosmetics a branch of medicine. And so in that way, we can, by studying the Etruscan women, we can understand ourselves in a deeper way and find spiritual and scientific meaning in our daily rituals and routines. Thank you.